This is Peepaw's Farm. This is a truly fascinating game because it's a game you can complete in under 5 minutes and get all of the achievements. So this doubles as me kind of doing a bit of a review and also a complete walkthrough of the game. It's quite fascinating. The developer was basically like, you know, are you sure you want to cover it? This is the type of game this is. And I think it's really sort of fascinating because they showed me like a video and it's like, this is the game. And it's like, and I'm like, oh, this is really interesting. I'd like to cover this because, A, you know, for you achievement hunters out there, this is a very quick completion. You skip through the dialogue as fast as you can. And if you follow my steps exactly here and do everything I do, you'll unlock the full 1,000 gamer score in literally under 5 minutes. I think it's like 3.5 minutes or something. And I just kind of like sit there on the menu afterwards or whatever. And, you know, anyways. So again, following the steps, going to talk to Charlotte, you talk to the pig first, then you go to Charlotte, and then, you know, we're going to go over here, and we're going to collect something else. We got to do this in a specific step. So I was first alerted to this game by a pal I have on Xbox and on Twitter and stuff named K4nage or Carnage, and I'll have his YouTube channel in the description. He covers achievements in games, and he just brought this to my attention. You collect the apple here. Make sure you collect specifically what I'm collecting. When you see that on the screen, you have to do everything specific just to get this done perfectly, then go and talk to the scarecrow. But, you know, he kind of brought this game to my attention, and I was like, this is really interesting, because, you know, I'm trying to get closer to a 500,000 gamer score. I'm very, very close. I'm a few thousand away at this point, talking. But, yeah, and then collect the tomatoes, and then we have to collect another crop here. And I was just like, this is a really interesting game, and I kind of wondered the concept of whether this type of game should exist, because, I mean, we've seen many games that have released that are very simple and you can get gamer score really fast, but usually there's more to the game past the point of you getting all the achievements so you can play a full game. Whereas this literally seems to exist just to pad your gamer score. I guess you could replay it a few times, but I don't really see the point in it. You know, there's a good example like Avatar, you gotta go over here and grab the old smelly hat, specifically like I'm doing for collecting stuff, you know, collecting those crops, grabbing the hat, going back, and then talking, or well, I guess dropping this off and then doing some other stuff. Anyways, this one is literally like a quick achievement thing. Avatar the Burning Earth, which was on the 360, was an easy 5 minutes for all the gamer score if you do it right. But that game had a full game afterwards to it. And there's been numerous titles, like I mentioned, where you can, you know, play through them and you can get the achievements, specifically one pumpkin there, guys, where you can get all the achievements. And this one, literally, there's nothing past it. It's just doing that, getting the gamer score, and then moving on, which I think is a bit of a shame, actually, because I like the visual aesthetic of this world area. I like the kind of goals and missions you do. If the concept would have been taken further, that's another one of the gadgets you gotta collect. This could have been a really, truly great experience, talking to the pig right now, and I'm just, like, a little kind of disappointed not to see a full-scope realization of this. And at the same time, to review it is weird, because it's not really much of a game at all. It's literally just something to game the system of achievements and go talk to the scarecrow and drop this stuff off. There's not really any point to it other than, hey, I'm going to get some quick gamer score. And while I appreciate that, I know for some people it's kind of like, well, what is the point of this? It's not a game, and the last pumpkin, you know, there's not really anything to it. And make sure before you drop this stuff off that you have to, I don't know, do we specifically? I think we got to talk to... Yeah, okay. So we load the truck. You gotta watch this very specifically at the end here, otherwise you have to redo it. But I mean, it's like 5 minutes, so it's not the biggest deal in the world. And then you go talk to Charlotte, and then you've gotta go do something else in the field, which is a bit of a funny Easter egg joke thing. But, you know, it's kind of like, should this type of game actually exist? I know that the industry of, you know, gaming and gamer score is so inflated and saturated these days that we've seen many things like this. But it's like, What point does this really serve in gaming, or is the idea that maybe really short games could be fun and could exist and actually have, you know, like a bit of a purpose, or is it just like you're kind of wondering about the value here? Because like I said, if you're an achievement hunter and you're working through this, be careful not to get glitched on this thing, by the way. You can, you know, kind of fly up on it and be stuck. But, you know, when I think about it, it's like, should these types of games be able to exist? Like, does it kind of ruin the system for getting achievements? Or is this a welcome sort of experimental type game that adds something unique to the experience? And I wish that the Series X achievements popped up, like, so you could see them overlaid, because I literally did this in one go. You know, if you followed this specific guide, I guess you could do the same. But, you know, it's just like, does this type of game have a point or an existence within this ecosystem, and I'm curious to see if they're going to do more, because I imagine some people, and I know a lot of people that do pick up these types of games just for the achievements, and, you know, if you're looking for one to give a quick boost, I guess this is it, but that's really all there is to the game. There's not much to it. You finish it, I guess you uninstall it afterwards, and you enjoy your achievements, because that's what this is for, basically.